Our six participants, four lowering, presumably I get their positions correct, four lowering it from 18 to 16, Nina Naik, head of the Juvenile Justice Board of Delhi, Kajal Menon, former director of Childline, and Vikas Singh, former additional Solicitor General. Against lowering it is Rahul Ishwar, social activist from Thiruvananthapuram, Dr. Kavita Sharma, former principal of Hindu College, well-known educationist from Delhi, and Syed Inayatullah, president of the Indian National League. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll go for and against right at the start of this debate. And my first question is to Kajal Menon, who's with me here in the studio. The argument against lowering would be that, among others, there's several arguments, is that it's violative of the rights of 5 crore children under the Constitution who are in this age bracket to leave them at the mercy of adult sexual abusers. A 16-year-old girl who can potentially, as a result of lowering this, be left at the mercy of a 50-year-old college professor, for example. Your response.
Okay, just to respond, you know, this violation can be at any age, at any time, and I think there are laws to really take care of that. But I vehemently am for lowering of the age to 16, because I, you know, agree with many views that are there, and I think Ambika Soni just mentioned that, you know, taking into account the social reality that exists today, taking into account, you know, onset of puberty, which is earlier.
Okay.
And taking the balance between what we are doing for children, their sexual rights, when it's consensual, as opposed to, you know, protecting the rights of them not getting abused. Well, a much more nuanced could be what other countries do, a tiered consensual law, which means, you know, if the consensual partners, if the age gap is a very small age gap, 2 to 3 years, then we don't criminalize it. And if the age gap is huge, we criminalize it as a deterrent effect. Of course, this nuanced kind of things is aspirational in a country such as India, that we moved to lower from 18 to 16 itself is a good step forward. And I think we should absolutely move forward.
Rahul Ishwar, the first part of Kajal Menon's argument, also put by many, is get real and move with the times. You know,
Arnab ji, three things.
Yeah, okay, go ahead.
The age of marriage in our land is 18. Does the government mean to say that we will have honeymoon first and marriage later? Second, the changing reality is changing at a very fast rate. So shall we assume that after 20 years we will again lower it to 14 or 15 where they will get sexually mature? Third point, the parent, any good-hearted parent or any person who is concerned about youngsters will not feel comfortable about this decision. We are leaving these children at the mercy of some serial abusers, some rapists who can coerce any so-called consent. And recent thing happened in Kerala too, which was a subject of great controversy. A 16-year-old girl raped by 42 men. You can argue that at the age of 62, she was having something like a child prostitution. But it, you know, you can argue that. It's a very strong argument, very tough to defeat in an argument, but then we will be defeating the very soul, very intention of such laws. So let us, I understand there are social changes, but let us not sanctify, let us not legalize, let us give them sex education, value education at an earlier age, but let us have some sanctity for these kind of relation. Unless our civilization, the idea of monogamous marriage will all be on decline, as it is already then, we will be catalyzing the process of decline.
Well, the argument put here is also this, Nina Naik. Respond to that. And the argument is, what about teenage pregnancies? What about unmarried, very young mothers? Coming to you, I'll come to you, Syed Inayatullah. I'm going four against. What about an increase in the number of illegitimate children? Does our state, which has no social security anyway, have a plan of action?
Arnab, first of all, I represent NCPCR. I'm not from any JJB. Let me make that clear.
I am extremely sorry for that.
Mistake twice. Yeah, but see, what we see, we are making a reality check. Like Kajal said, this is the reality. I mean, youngsters are maturing faster, and then there is a lot of exploration. And if you look at the new act, I think this ordinance, you must see it in light of the new act, that the protection of children against sexual offenses. There are gradations of sexual assault. So if, just to the 16 to 18 years, they're exploring each other, they're having some sexual activity with the consent of the girl, and parents oppose it, this is what happens. They start criminalizing the boys. We have many of these institutions which I visit across the country. I've seen young girls, 16, 17 who are in homes, and boys' cases have been booked.
No, you answer the question. Answer the question of potential exploitation. The question that Rahul Ishwar puts is a question of potential exploitation.
No, if it is not a concern, definitely. No, if it is girl says it's not a concern, then definitely.
So are you saying that all 16-year-old girls in India are very much strongly in a position to take informed consent when it deals? If they have to deal with somebody two or three times
their
age. See,
if you look at this new act, the protection of children. No, if you look at the protection of child against sexual assault.
Yeah.
Look at that new act, and you'll see that the burden of proof is a man to prove. So the girl doesn't have to say anything. If the girl says that she did not give her consent.
No, what about teenage pregnancies? What about unmarried, very young mothers? What about an increase in illegitimate children? The burden will be on the woman. The burden will be on the woman, and this has happened in other parts of the world. Coming back to you, Kajal Mehra. Let's get Syed Inayatullah in. Syed Inayatullah.
See, apart from being a politician, I'd like to bring to your notice that I was a former member in Juvenile Justice Board in Chennai for 3 years. That is a tenure from 2002 to 2005. By virtue of my experience, there I have seen the boys and the girls who were 16 years old, how they have committed the crime. Now,
what
we
crime?
Are just debating
no,
on
what
the
crime?
Subjective issue.
No.
Like crime of murder, rape, okay. And other theft and so many things. But here, particularly now, this debate is subjective debate. Let us not look into it as a subjective debate. Let us go as an objective debate. Now, the primary instinct of a boy and girl, always the first thirst, second hunger, third sex. Nobody teaches these three primary instincts. It is in the human tendency. Now at the age of 11.5 average age, the girl gets puberty, whereas the boy at the age of 12.5 or 13, he gets the puberty. So then the sexual urge automatically comes into them, and they don't know what to do. They are in a strong and stressful age. So we cannot say that 16, that is why I am not bringing the Islam inside, but however, let me say that in Islam, once the boy or girl attained the puberty, they are ready to get married. It is better for them to get married. But now, due to the situation, what we are having, the economic situation, the educational system, we are not allowing the boy and girls are getting married as soon as they get the puberty. We are allowing them to go for college. In olden days, in villages, even in cities, the girls were not allowed to go beyond matric, beyond 10th standard.
Yeah.
But now the girls are going for professional courses like that. Now, I'm coming to you. The why it is, the 16 years age, why do you want to bring it? It is not correct. Because in the age of 16, he will not understand what he is doing, what he is thinking. He is not mature enough.
That may be your view.
First of all, let me bring it.
That may be your view. One second. Sir, then I'll come back to you. I want to take everyone's view. I'm coming back to you, sir. The argument put by both Syed Inayatullah and others is that you are not in a position at 16. In other words, Vikas Singh, they are saying at 16 you are not physiologically or emotionally mature. You may be biologically capable of having sex, but you're not physiologically or emotionally mature to deal with the consequences of having sex, Vikas Singh.
Well, after because, according to me, I will give it to the government.
Yes, Vikas.
That they would have done their homework. They would have done their homework before bringing this legislation, because definitely there would be some study available with them to suggest that children are getting maturer earlier. Now, I have always been of the view that this kind of a lowering also should be done even in the case of Juvenile Justice Act, because ultimately what is the purpose of having a juvenile, having that protection under the Act? One of the main reasons for having that protection is that he is considered to be immature and the society has failed him. So till he becomes mature, he should not be made to suffer the consequences of what he has done. So it's in that sense a knee-jerk reaction. If you do a lowering of consent age as far as this is concerned, on the basis that a person has become mature to have sex, and at the same time you say that no, he is still a juvenile till 18, according to me, this is something where the government has, according to me, not done its homework properly. If you ask me, in a lot of these Western countries now, the discretion is left with the court to decide as to what circumstances in which the particular juvenile has grown, whether the society has failed him or whether he was mature enough to understand the gravity of what he was doing. If you can trust the judicial system to convict a person on the basis of whether he has done something or not, I'm sure you can trust the judicial system to also have this discretion that they will exercise.
Kavita Sharma.
And see that if a boy, or girl has been failed by the society, then he should not be made to suffer the consequences. Whereas
no, I understand you're taking a very legal point of view. You are taking a very completely. My point is, however, about the changing social setup. And Kavita Sharma, you've been principal of a college, you've dealt with young adults. Is it true or not the social setup has changed?
Yes.
People are more sexually active at an earlier age, and reducing age is an acknowledgement of our changing times. Older generation becoming too diffident?
Of course it has.
Yeah.
No. The puberty, onset of puberty is early, the intermingling is far more.
So?
And all of that is true. But I, as an educationist, would say to you that there must be some time and space in a person's life to grow physically, mentally, emotionally, psychologically, ethically. And if you say that at the age of 16, it's all right to have your head filled with sex, then I'm afraid you are being too pragmatic. I mean, for that matter, people are experimenting with drugs, people are experimenting with liquor. So, would you say that, all right, at the age of 16, you should be able to buy liquor, you should be able to buy drugs? I mean, where does this pragmatism end? Do we not want our children to have time to mature and grow and make something of themselves?
No, but does lowering the age of consent promote sexual behavior?